A very warm welcome back. We're in the Northern Cape today, Mokala National Park, in fact, which is a new addition to the parks. It should be offering more to tourists that visit the Northern Cape and come to this part of the world. And part of that cultural experience is watching dancers such as the Kunkwesa cultural group that you're seeing at the moment from Platfontein, which is just outside Kimberley, because that's where we are actually. We're about 85 kilometers south of Kimberley in the Mokala National Park at the beginning of Sand Parks Week. And of course, you'll know that it's Heritage Month as well. And heritage involves not just our fauna and flora, but as you can see, our dancers as well that are celebrating all that is wonderful about South Africa at the moment. And this province belongs to Premier Sylvia Lucas, who's a child of this part of the world, and she joins me now. Premier, thank you very much for joining us on the program, and welcome to you.
Thank you very much, Peter, and good morning to your viewers out there.
All right, so
in my own province.
So this is home for you, isn't it? And I would imagine that a park like this coming into being 2007, but it's been growing steadily since then. And also because that you were also a former MEC for Environment and Conservation, this is something that's close to your heart.
No, for sure. It's very close to my heart. And especially, like you've said, it's Heritage Month. It's also Tourism Month. So the natural heritage is one of the things that we as the Northern Cape think that we can expand more in terms of growing our stake in the tourism fraternity to make sure that we do get more out of it. And we are having this wide open spaces, this tranquility that they speak about. And that is what we can offer. And I was just listening to the to Dr. Mabunda saying that Mokala has been growing by 20% each year ever since its inception. And you can see it's offering something different. It's offering really something different. And that is what the Northern Cape is offering. That's why you will see we've got extreme culture, extreme adventure, extreme sport. That is what we are offering in terms of tourism. And Mokala is just rightly placed, correctly placed within the whole realm of what we want to reach as the Northern Cape in terms of our tourism and heritage potential.
Now, you lived in this part of the world pretty much all your life. What kind of a difference has Mokala made?
Mokala has been contributing a lot to the economy because tourism is one of the pillars of our economy in the Northern Cape. Although we are still just getting a small stake of like 1.2% of the international visitors and about 2% of the total domestic product of tourism within the country is the Northern Cape. But it has steadily been growing. We as the Northern Cape, we have got around about 6 national parks and 2 transfrontier parks in the Northern Cape. We have also just revitalized our 6 provincial reserves, and we are very soon we took some of our savings to make sure that we do equip these reserves so that more people can be able to come and have that experience that we are speaking about, the tranquility, the clean air, the open spaces, the variety of species that you find in terms of the, especially the fauna and the flora that you find if you look at Namakwa. Anyway, we've got a lot to offer in terms of tourism, in terms of our natural heritage, in terms of our cultural heritage. We've got a lot to offer. And that is why we're saying that we really see tourism as a very strong leg of our economy within our province. And even the issue of conservation, it's also something that is very important. We've got more than 1 million hectare under conservation currently. And we are also expanding in terms of working with private land owners to make sure that where they've got some exotic or even species that are indigenous in the province, that we work with them, together with them, and forge partnerships to make sure that we've got more land under conservation so that we can really build up our conservation estate as a province.
Conservation, clearly something also very important to you. And again, I'm drawing on your experience as a child of this province. And I'm wondering, are people taking to conservation in this part of the world over time now?
I think the issue was just to make sure that you raise consciousness and that you really educate people. And I think that is what we have succeeded in since 2009, taking over the portfolio. I realized that there was a lot of good things happening, of which it is not really up in the in the public arena. So we started with campaigns, with consciousness raising, and all that kind of programs that we have embarked on. And now you will see that you even get requests from especially previously disadvantaged schools and communities to say, can we become part of this box? Can we also become part of whatever you are doing? If you like Friday, we have been celebrating Arbor Week, and all over people were busy realizing that our green heritage is something that we need to build on. So the whole issue of conservation, it was just about raising the consciousness of our people and campaigning and educating them. And I think we are getting real results in terms of the issue of conservation. And if you actually go into the areas, you find that our people has got the indigenous knowledge, and it's just that it has not been tapped on. And now that we are really going into the issue of conservation, opening up the whole topic of conservation, you can see that people are coming to the front saying, MEC, especially when I was still the MEC, I know about this bush, it's got medicinal value, and so on and so on. So you can see that people have been sitting with it, but they didn't know where to go. They didn't know where to really disclose that they have got this indigenous knowledge and what we can do about the conservation of our.
Premier Lucas, it sounds like that you're quite excited about your province. And now that you're at the helm as Premier, that your vision is to continue to grow this province, particularly tourism and conservation. Well, we certainly wish you the best of luck, and thank you so much for giving us this opportunity to talk to you.
Thank you very much, Peter, and thank you very much to the viewers for giving us the opportunity. And I hope people will be streaming to our national parks in this week, because it's free of charge and it's open to everyone.
Fantastic. Premier, thank you very much indeed. So that's Premier Sylvia Lucas talking to us here. She's the Premier of this province, where she's lived all her life, and she's very proud of this province. And as she says, come down, it's changing. There's lots to see and do in this part of the world. Let's go.